You're hosting Saturday Night Live for the first time.
Who?
You. Congratulations.
What?
Yeah. You're just finding the set now?
This week?
Dude, you're going to love it. You're fantastic in it. I already saw it. Are you nervous? Are you excited?
Yeah, I'm really excited. I mean, I've never done it, and it seems a little bit scary, but also just amazing. It's like, it's, you know, it's a show I grew up watching. It's the best.
How's it feel? Did you see the set yet? Did you start rehearsing?
I started poking around a little bit. I was like, wow, Jimmy Fallon stood there.
Yeah, right.
Jimmy Fallon stood there.
Yeah, and Jimmy stood over there, yeah. Did you ever do live theater or anything?
I started my career in live theater, actually. I was in kindergarten, and
Oh, yeah, of course.
It was a good show. My school was called, it was named after Rosa Parks, you know, the late, great civil rights activist, and... I don't know why they, but she found out about it. We were in Massachusetts. She lived down in the South, and she actually came up. She was 70-something years old, and she came up to, because she felt honored, she came to visit the school, and so we put on a little performance for her, and I was a lion. What I had to do was run up to the front of the stage and roar and get off stage. And it was going to be good, but my mane fell off. I had a mane, and it was at my very first artistic crisis. I was a performer, and I thought, like, do I go back and pick up the mane? Do I just go ahead and roar? Will they know what I am if I don't have a mane?
Like, what? You're just like an orange dude, yeah. And a onesie. You're wearing a onesie, yeah, exactly, yeah.
And so I went back, picked it up. I did the roar. I got off stage, and afterward, Rosa Parks patted me on the head and smiled at me, which was pretty amazing. And then I've been since then. My whole career has been trying to recapture that feeling of approval. And that's what I'm looking for. So it's not just about being on Saturday Night Live. It's kind of about working through some early childhood trauma. That's why you do this.
Please trust me. Yeah, this is therapy, absolutely, yeah.